Downtown Cleveland continues to experience rapid growth. It is attracting more than just new businesses and residents. Right now, the city is trying to tackle a sharp rise in the number of panhandlers. News 5's Mike Brookbank caught up with one local agency that says it has a solution.
Yeah, for years, the city of Cleveland has tried solving its panhandling problem with police. This, according to the Northeast Ohio Coalition for the Homeless. And now that the city has dropped its aggressive solicitation ordinance, which was being challenged in court, NEOC says now is the time for a new approach.
I get asked every day, do you have some money? Da-da-da-da. And if I say no, sometimes they yell at me and, you know, call me names.
Ty Burt's experience in downtown Cleveland lately,
it's most definitely the same people every single day,
is becoming more commonplace.
In the past few months, I would say definitely, yeah.
Matt Shaver tells me he is approached by people begging for money on these streets every single day.
On my way to get my haircut today, there was a guy who came out to me asking for money. So normally it's a pretty common occurrence.
As for why we're seeing an uptick now,
we haven't done much to address poverty, and lots of people are struggling, can't find a job.
Add to that the growing popularity of downtown.
So you have more pedestrian traffic, you're going to see an increase in panhandling.
It's a problem Brian Davis and others encouraged the city and the Downtown Cleveland Alliance to tackle last year ahead of the Republican National Convention.
They said it was too expensive, and they weren't interested.
The plan they passed on addressed panhandling with a social service response.
By hiring outreach workers, going out, engaging panhandlers, saying what can we do to get you a job or get you some income so that you don't have to beg anymore.
Davis tells me other cities have seen success going this route. Until we see what's next for Cleveland, residents like Matt Schaefer know they will continue to come across people in need.
It's not terrible.
Part of living in
a city. Yeah, it's part of living in a city, correct.
A spokesperson with the Downtown Cleveland Alliance tells me they have no comment on changes to the city's panhandling law. And when pressed about responding to the concerns of those who live and work downtown, I was once again told no comment. Reporting downtown tonight, Mike Brookbank, News 5. And